Kwanza kabisa, let me thank you teachers. You are the only people who knew Mandago in 2013. The rest of the citizens of this county, they never knew who Mandago was. You are the only people who understood my capabilities. And you are the only people who believed and trusted in my candidature and my leadership as the governor of this county. Today I stand here very proud to say I have delivered in the pledges I made. And if we are to do a mean score, if worse comes to worse, I cannot do below 65%. It is a good belief. Most of you teach in various institutions in this county. And you know the challenge you used to have to reach your school. Today, whether you are riding about a border or driving or working, you are guaranteed to reach your working station. Those of you who teach in this town, and those of you who live within this town, understand that there used to be a serious challenge of security in this county before we came in. Every weekend, you would not miss to hear a gunshot. Every day, you would not miss to hear a wailing woman, bagi yangu imeenda. Every other time, you would not miss to hear a young man saying, simu yangu imeenda. Today, in this town, you can freely walk, whether it is day or night, because we have worked to improve the security situation in this county. Today, this town looks better than it was 2013. From independence to 2012, we had only two bridges crossing River Sosheni. Under 4 years, my administration has built 6 bridges along River Sosheni. And not just building bridges, but building them cost effectively. I remember when we did the FIMS bridge, some crooks wrote letters to ESCC. Najua Mandago, amejenga bridge ya 150 million. Nakula. So one time I was going about my business. Naambiwa kuna watu wameonekana FIMS bridge looking suspicious. Nikauliza what are they doing? Kidogo nikaambiwa oh ni watu ya ESCC nasemekana umekula hii pesa hii bridge. And you know they have come with engineers from Kenya National Highways Authority from Nairobi. They would not trust even the regional manager here. So when the general manager in charge of maintenance was asked, after they had looked at the bridge, they said the quality is okay, but the cost is where we have a problem. So akauliza ule GM, wewe ukiona hii daraja, by your estimation as a professional engineer, how much is it? Akasema, at the least, be around 75 million to 80. So 150 is a serious exaggeration. Now when they walked to our office, they were surprised that we did the bridge at a cost of 25 million. Sasa, hapo sasa ndio bwangu akapata bwaguzi. Nikaambia watu ya Kenya, where have you been taking 55 million, my friend? For every bridge you are building, you are stealing 55 million. Ni kama wale majambazi wa zamani. Kawaja wanalima administration ya Jubilee atini waizi. Sisi tunatengeneza kilomita moja ya lami at a maximum of 45 million. Previously, and you can go to Nandi County. Iko barabara inatoka pale inaenda Kapte, about 10 kilometers. It was done at a cost of 1.6 billion. 100 million per kilometer. Sasa tukauliza, hii 55 million ingine ilikuwa inaenda na nani hapo zamani. Kwa hivyo wezi ni wengi ni ile hawakushikwa kwa wakati wao. When we took over also, and part of my play was to deliver on the ECD program. Today your teachers and most of the schools, as we speak today, we've built more than 580 ECD centers in this county. And we've also relieved the parents the burden of paying salaries for those ECD teachers. Today, although we pay them a modest sum of 10,000, that 10,000 is regular and guaranteed. Unlike the 2,000 but they were not sure and it was not guaranteed.
Yeah.
And you know the challenge we have had is when Nan went to court to say, you know, counties cannot employ teachers. I told them myself because I worked in TAC and I've been in the ministry for 16 years. For all those years, the government had been planning to recruit ECDE teachers for the 16 years I was in service, but they never did it. Let me say, temporarily, why can they allow us to pay when they are ready? We hand them over to them. See, they do not better to live a mushara, but we are addressing an immediate need that is there.
Yeah.
Luckily, the court has ruled that we can take charge of that function, but we only expect TSC to give us a scheme of service. Then we can correctly place all those teachers and absorb them under permanent and pensionable terms. Each and every public primary school in this county has two ECD teachers employed and paid by the county government of Uasin Gishu. Over and above that, recognizing the challenges we have on the level of technician skills we need in this county, we have taken through more than 1,800 young men and women through certificate, artisan, and diploma courses in RVTTI, specifically on four areas of concern to us. One is on electrical, the other one is civil, building, plumbing, and these others, masonry, carpentry, and others. Why are we doing that? Because we realize that a lot of government resources are actually expended through infrastructure development. And what is happening in this country? We are going to China, borrowing money to build our roads. And because you come from this county, you know, the national government is doing Eldoret, Elola, Elgeyo border, Iten road at a cost of almost 1.8 billion. They are doing Bryce, Naiberi, at a cost of almost 2.something billion. All that money is borrowed money from China. That money has arrived in Kenya. But the Chinese have followed the money back up Plateau. And I personally have a problem with these Chinese because when they come, number one, they will never buy a single cloth from any shop in this town. They normally come with three pairs of clothes, full stop. They will never live in anybody's hotel, whether they are senior managers or directors or what, they will live in the labor campsite. Have you ever seen a Chinese renting a house? Even food, they will bring their food from China. Ile chakula tu sosa extra, ni wakipata umbo yako ikirandaranda. What does that tell you? It means if we borrow 5 billion from China, the Chinese will take back home 4.5 billion and they will only leave us with casual money in this country. That is why national government is spending a lot of money in infrastructure, but we are not feeling the stimulation of the economy because the money is being repatriated. And that is the basic reason why we say it as a county, we want to prepare technicians, we want to prepare those at diploma level, because we feel we have sufficient graduates, but they need to be backed up so that when we go to the next phase of maintaining these so many thousands of kilometers of roads, we shall have local contractors who will then retain the money in Eldoret and stimulate the economy of this county. And those doing diploma programs, we've also tied it to a national government program. Once they qualify this July, we intend to sponsor at least of those doing diploma, 400 to Kenyan Technical Teachers College, so that they become teachers like you. Why are we doing that? Because the national government is building one technical training institute in every constituency. That means, come next year or September this year, the government would want to recruit teachers of these TTIs who have technical skills, but they are also teachers. Whether people like it or not, they are going to recruit at least 400 from Uasin Gishu County by linking that program to what we are doing in the county. So when we talk about serious transformation and means of empowering people, my administration is very serious and thorough in terms of thinking what can be done to reverse the negative trends that have been affecting our economy. In the other sectors, in agriculture, we've done a lot of subsidy, whether it is AI, whether they are parasites, and today our farmers can dip their cows at a minimum cost of 10 shillings a cow. That means a cow only needs 1 liter of milk in a month to be disease-free. And the rest of the milk is left to you to deal with it. So ladies and gentlemen, because your AGM was not my political run, let me appeal that you re-elect me for a second term as your governor. Because I am serious about working and developing this country. And I also want to assure you, as your colleague, that regardless of these rumors my competitors have been rumoring around, the governor may have 4.5 billion. Kwani mtu ameiba 4.5 billion na wewe unaonekana hata kwa sura? And how comes all the institutions responsible for ensuring proper use of public resources have never asked Mandago to record any statement? Because we have EACC, we have Efficiency Monitoring Unit, we have the Auditor General, and I dare say if we have a coward in this country, it's the Auditor General. He was asked to account for 100 million from his office on some procurement of a software. He rushes to court to say, I should not be summoned. Then why should he be asking us to be summoned as governors? I'm the only governor in this country who said, if Senate says, come and tell us where you, how you spend the money, I will not engage in a useless debate. Oh, I'm not coming. Oh, senators are not supposed to summon. I told them myself, I want to arrive there at 8:30. Because I know where the money has gone. I know the programs we have engaged as a county. The only problem we have in this town that we must acknowledge, and I've said myself as your leader, I will never be embarrassed to say what my government has not been able to address. Because if you want to lead, we cannot lead with lies. The only problem we are facing in this town is Manene hawkers. And why we have not resolved the issue of hawkers is because of the same fellow who keeps inciting them and he doesn't want them to join the cooperative movement. You can ask these officers. When we came in, the Matatu sector was in disarray. But when they accepted to join the cooperative movement, today, Langa's 20 minibus circle was voted the best Matatu circle in this country. Border business, so many counties, including the National Transport and Safety Authority, have come to this county to benchmark on how we have handled border, on how border are about to go their business without being a security concern. There was a time every robbery, every crime involved a border. These days you don't hear of that. Because we've made reforms, we've engaged those stakeholders through the cooperative movement, and I'm telling you, if those workers go to cooperative movement, we are going to engage them, and that running around will be a thing of the past. Otherwise, Manene akufukuzana town is historical in nature, and it is normal. Town ni kwaso. Town ni kwaso. We've done work equitably this time around in this county. Kienda mahali kama ngenjile, siju watu wangapo natoka ngenjile na huko kwenu kulikuwa na barabara kweli? Na siku hizi watu ya corona meibeki. Kwenu kulikuwa na barabara kabla Mandago kukuje? And these days, do you feel you are now part of government? Watu wa Timborua Madharu, hawako wanajulikana kama wako Kericho County, ama wako Uasin Gishu County. Ama waibate. Services imewafikia. Now they are feeling part and parcel of this county. Ladies and gentlemen, I am appealing to you. I am not a lazy person. I am not a thief. I've learned to live within my means all the rest of my life.